So we'll start here.
Okay,
so today we're here with Archie and we're working on some kennel games, and this is to help him build up a really positive association with the kennel. We just had him go into the kennel. I tossed a bunch of treats in there. When he walked in on his own and ate the treats, I said the word kennel. Now what we want to do, and this is going to help build up self-control but also some kennel drive, is I'm going to help him not come racing out of the kennel. And you want to do this each time he's in the kennel to come out. So at this point, we want to have a release word. Our release word is the word break. And so when he's allowed to come out, we're going to say the word break and give him a treat. Over time, you want to be able to move farther and farther away from the kennel and be able to say the word kennel, have him race into the kennel, stay in the kennel with the door open, and then you say the word break. And it becomes kind of a fun game, but it teaches your dog that this is a fun, exciting place to run into, and then they're going to get yummy treats out of it. So what we want to do to help build up the self-control is to just kind of start to open the door, and each time he tries to come out, we just shut the door. We did practice this. This is not a dry run. We've done this off camera, so he's a little more familiar with it than the first time. But notice, even before he tries to walk out, I close the door just to help teach him not to come walking out. This time, also notice that because he didn't try too hard, I didn't shut the door all the way to teach him essentially that he was doing a good job by waiting a second. Break. So I'm going to give him a treat. Then I have a treat right again in my hand. I'm going to toss it all the way into the back. Ignore him for a second. See if he makes the decision on his own. Remember, by ignoring, it also means don't make eye contact with him. Kennel. So I said the word kennel when he ate the treat. Now we're going to do it again. And this is only the third or fourth time we've done this, and we're getting to the point where we almost have the door open all the way. Break the first time with him staying in the kennel all on his own. So he's starting to really catch on to this really quickly. So right now I'm just putting the treat right on in front of his nose to kind of get him a little more excited. I'm going to toss two in. Kennel. And again, so we want to keep practicing this until after a couple of days. You can say the word kennel before he goes into it, maybe when you toss the treats in. Break. Good boy. But I would wait for him to get to the point where he's running in a little bit faster. Kennel. Okay, buddy. Ready? He's really hopeful that there might be some out here. But essentially you want to build this up into a fun game where you can increase your distance and say the word kennel. Kennel. Good. Break. Good. And that's the last treat. So he gets to the point where not only will he go in and then stay in the kennel without you needing to shut the door. So the next step would be getting him to go in. You say the word kennel, toss the treat in, and then get to the point where you can leave the door open and he doesn't come out until you say the word break. And then you increase your distance. So then you start to move a little farther. At first, and it sounds funny, but going even this far away from the kennel will be a big thing to him. So when you start off, you need to move little steps, like up until the point where you're about 5 feet away, you need to move in inches away from the kennel. Once you get to about 5 feet away, you can probably start moving in feet. You can move like another foot back and another foot back and start changing it up. But this will teach him to have the kennel be a fun game and a place to run into. You'll start to get to the point where you're going to say kennel and he's going to race into it and look at it as a fun game, and it just builds up that positive association and helps him listen really well to you as well. So that's how we're going to do kennel training, and this is one version of a crate game. Good boy, good boy, good boy, good boy.